Before my presentation, let's test it. Alexa, open Bebaz Art.
Okay, what can I do for you?
Can you show me my collection on Bebaz canvas?
Sorry, unknown art word.
Alexa, open Bebaz Art.
Okay, what can I do for you?
Can you show me abstract art?
Okay, I will show you abstract artworks.
Okay, let's get started. Thank you. My name is Clara Shin. 한국 이름은 신세윤입니다. Thank you for coming all the way down from somewhere in order to listen to our presentation today. Oops, well, that's wrong slide, sorry. Bebaz Art is a social marketplace for talented and emerging artists and serious and sincere art lovers around the world. At Bebaz Art, emerging artists can freely showcase their creative outputs and art lovers can connect with them by expressing their feelings and emotions on art. Like a startup ecosystem, Bebaz Art is a cradle where talented emerging artists can receive proper nourishment to become future Picasso for the next century. Currently, we have about 550,000 art lovers are enjoying more than 45,000 artworks by 17,000 emerging artists around the world. Our user bases are pretty global, representing more than 150 countries, and we are frequently featured at Google Play and Apple App Store. In order to monetize the startup, we trade original artworks on our platform, but we realize that the distance between artwork and the public is still very far. Let's face the reality. I mean, if you have a disposable income of $1,000, you are not going to buy art. Instead, what you are going to do, you buy your personal necessity, such as going to take a trip or buying luxury items, you know? But then you're not going to buy art. But as a way to shorten the distance between artwork and the public, we provide curation streaming service, combining machine art analysis and human curatorial insight. We provide exciting, interesting, and easy artworks that people can use day-to-day basis. Let me tell you, our art curation is not difficult at all. Do you understand the word existentialistic art? I don't. I mean, I'm a pretty much native speaker, but I don't understand what that means. But then we provide curation such as, you know, different styles of artwork, group of artwork that you might want to enjoy on your dark, rainy day, in slush, or curated artworks that you want to go along with your favorite music. We even connect our curation streaming service with AI speakers around the world in order to open a new door to art appreciation system under the umbrella of Fourth Industrial Revolution. And let me demonstrate a bit. Alexa, open Bebaz Art.
Okay, what can I do for you?
Can you show me realistic art?
Okay, I will show you realistic artworks.
And then it'll change after 10 seconds. Actually, you have an application that goes with it. I shouldn't say application, it's a remote that you can change the time sequences, you can change different curations. Okay, let's try a different one. Alexa, open Bebaz Art.
Okay, what can I do for you?
Can you play Johann Sebastian Bach's cantata?
Okay. Enjoy Johann Sebastian Bach's cantata with great artworks.
Alexa, stop. Thank you. I take it as a compliment. Imagine a world where every household can enjoy an easy, have an easy access to fine art. Your conversation amongst household members will be very deep and philosophical. Your child's imagination will be enlarged. The high and tough barrier of fine art will be eroded away, and the emerging artists will have more opportunity to showcase. And that's the goal that we are striving for. Our action will be persistent, and our goal and mission will be consistent. Until the last emerging artist claims creativity, B-Baza will continue our glorious and beautiful march. Thank you.
Very interesting.
Thank you.
Arts and culture is something that we always need for daily life.
Yes.
First question, both me and Anna had, like, we wonder, what are you really selling? Are you selling the art itself as a painting, or are you selling the streaming service?
Both, sir. Yes, emerging artists have this, I should say, art industry is still very conservative in a sense that they want to, they are very, they have a, how can I say, habitual or traditional mode of economic running. So they want to sell their original pieces, and that's their goal. But then it's very difficult. I mean, the average, average artworks that emerging artists sell per their entire lifetime before they become big is maybe five, less than five. So in order to have an easy access to the emerging artists or, you know, the art people, I mean, art lovers who love artwork, we provide curation stream. It's 2-year subscription, monthly basis.
I think it's good to have a combination. For example, if they become a premium user, then they can have unlimited picture, but they can even rent, let's say, 2 pieces of art, and to keep it for a certain time and then recycle it.
Yes, one of our one of our biggest market at this time for this curation streaming service is Shanghai, and our Chinese customers ask the same question, same request. They say, Clara, I'm gonna subscribe for 10 years. So can you give me 40% discount on the selective artworks? I said, by all means, sir, get it.
But is it physical art that they'll get, or is it, because right now is the way how you just combine the music with all this, is that just for choosing the art?
Okay. Well, it's...
Is it actually physical, or...?
Well, what I realized as the art professional for many years, it sort of like smears on you. If you see the work of art at the gallery or on the wall or Y-Cube, you're not going to buy art right away. You have the time to think about it, get close to it, touch it, and then you decide to buy it. This machine will shorten the distance between the public and art. So let them do the curation streaming service as long as they want it. But if they decide to purchase it, they can purchase it on our platform. And then we'll give you this good discount if they are the members of the subscribers.
When I hear the presentation, you remind me of another great Swedish company specialized in streaming music.
Yes.
Spotify.
Yes, sir. That's so very good.
That bring about in my brain that this company, your company, can have another name like Artify.
Yes. Right now, we are discussing launching our service with the Deutsche Telekom, and their AI speaker is Magenta. The SDK will be available in January 2019. And then the Spotify is the music service that the providing music to the Magenta. So we are actually talking right now in order to do Spotify, B-Buzz, Artify.
Exactly.
Yes, sir.
And I think this platform can be even interesting for unknown artists.
Yes,
so
sir.
So some artists would be willing to pay to be at the platform, and then by other people viewing that, then they will get money as well.
Yes, sir. Right now, the YouTube system, music streaming services, pay about 1 cent to the musicians right now, but then their music has to be, you know, streamed. But then we try to find, I shouldn't say decentralized, but then this is not blockchain, but then we try to find a way to support more, because it's a very loaded work of art. It's very serious products, not products, outcome, yes.
And another point I want to share with you that in every country, there is a Ministry of Culture,
of course.
Mm-hmm. Sweden probably is the only country who has a different name. Mm-hmm. It's called the Ministry of Culture and Democracy.
Democracy. Okay, that's interesting.
I didn't understand from the beginning, but their explanation is, you know, they think art and culture is a result of the democracy.
Yes.
Without democracy, you will have a propaganda, but that's not art.
Yes.
So that's why in Sweden, in the last 5-6 years, they put a lot of efforts on putting the democratic thinking in art.
Mm-hmm.
And that bring me an idea about this product can be can find a new market. For yes. example, in the classic museums, imagine in order to make it democratic, we could have one corner for every museum mm-hmm. to be a platform for unknown artists, but in the same character.
Yes.
And if this could be a national policy that mm-hmm. all museums have to have a corner
yes.
to give the same rights, the same access for the unknown artist.
Right.
And of course, they can select, they can filter the artist, and then this will be a huge market.
Yes, right now, I think you are very forward-thinking. That's a very good point, by the way. We're discussing with, I'm not going to say this because one of the museums in China, where you know, underdeveloped regions in China can have this canvas with the Jolie speaker from Vivo, and then they can have, hey Vivo, hey Jolie, can you show me Michelangelo's art? Can you show me Picasso's art? So that even though they cannot travel, they can still feel and they can still look the wonderful piece of art. And they can imagine.
Exactly. And this is a very good educational purpose as well.
Yes, sir.
And I think you should think more about the institutional customers.
Mm-hmm.
Why not for the hospitals, at the corridor, at some specific room, to let people enjoy the piece and art, which can be part of the therapy.
Thank you. I'll take it as a good compliment.
I'll ask a quick question. What's the business model right now?
Right now, we do the curation stream service. It's $50 per month under 2-year subscription. And we launched it 2 months ago, and then it's quite surprisingly, it's pretty popular. So
I'm not surprised actually.
Yeah. Thank you.
I love the service. And then you pay something to the. Do you pay anything right now to the actual artists, or it's more just promotion for them?
Well, right now we pay. We pay small fees of the content usage fee. It's a lot, but then in order to support, we still pay.
Yeah. Well, that's fair enough. I really love it, and I agree with a lot of things that Sandy said. I mean, maybe a quick kind of comment or tip from my side with regards to presentation, because I loved it, but I think maybe think about how you can crystallized a little bit better. What is it? A physical art? Is it a frame that streams and so on? So I think it will just help people to understand, you know, kind of the logic and what you're going after.
Okay.
But yeah, really like the service. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you. You have a great day.
Thank you. Next up is Victoria Productions. Victoria Productions' core product is Book Plus App, which allows content publishers to easily add excitement and animation to their existing texts. We have Brianna Jiang, the project manager of Victoria Productions. Please invite her to the stage with a big hand.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Brianna from Victoria Productions. Today, I'd like to take this time to help us all focus on the tremendous opportunity that AI, VR, MR has in store for our classrooms, teachers, and our kids. We, Victoria Productions, develop exciting, groundbreaking, multilingual AI, VR learning tools for children everywhere, especially for kids aged between 0 to 10. Starting from New York, we have developed a variety of contents and tools. And here's an example for your better understanding. So using your mobile or tablet, you can scan each tag of the book and interact with the 3D objects. And now you can learn English phonics as well. This one supports 15 different languages. So not just English, but also other languages. You can learn anything. Also, there is a recording function on the bottom of this page as well. You can also record yourself and practice yourself as well. With the purpose of making kids love reading more and interact with the book more, we just added gaming functions as well. This is not what we made. This animation is from other company. We have licensing with a lot of animation companies in Korea. So we developed Book Plus App, which means book publishing and app development using AI technology. So this book particularly has a function the kids can play with their favorite characters. They can move them around or make them dance or jump. Or some particular page, if you scan it, it goes to 3D animations. But not just watching the same animation, the same story. You can also record yourself and create a new story as well. So for example, the mom and dad, when they go to business trip, they can record their some new stories and for their kids. So when they're away, they can read themselves with their familiar voices. So now we have the largest number of the contents and products, including 150 book titles, 650 mobile applications. So some of you have seen these kind of products before. You might wonder, what is this so different than any other AI products, or why we are so different than AI, other AI companies? Well, we also built this powerful web contents platform using AR. All the products, all the contents we have developed, we have uploaded to the website and make it to the subscription-based model. So now you can access unlimited 150 book titles, and you can easily access and experience the AR anywhere you go, regardless of where you are. The way to use it is very simple. Simply use the your mobile and scan each book page on the browser, PC or TV monitor. You can also create the new story here and then share with other people as well. So imagine how many things we can do with the contents we have developed so far in technology. It's actually infinite. It's not just limited to the books, but also it can transform into different types of the products. We're now transforming them to kids' cafes or theme park using the own content. So this particular place where children go, they get this device at the entrance and they can scan anywhere they step into and they can interact with the 3D and 2D animations, also learn while having fun. So there's some AR photo functions or some characters also are popping up on the walls or anywhere. With being partnered with one of the Chinese company who has AR Keys robot, no, not just Keys robots, we have this package deal with Keys robots and our AR box. So it's a full set of presents for your kids, which can be your kids' reading body. We have a full set of team with designers and developers. We are based in New York, US. We have a company in Korea. And we have recently launched a Chinese joint venture in Guangzhou. What makes us different and best is that we do graphic design, book publishing, and app development, everything in-house. That's what makes us book quality better, the product's quality better. Our business model is not just limited to the books or educations, but also we do a lot of big projects with big companies in Korea using AI technology. So, for example, magazine brochures or some other business cards can have a layer of excitement using this technology. It's expandable because we also support up to 15 different languages. It's all market ready. We're currently looking for partners who can energize this industry and bring its benefits to the masses. Thank you very much.
It's a very interesting product, and can we go back to the page with the giraffe?
Sure. It's way back.
First question is like, what is the target age for the children?
It's a 0 to 10.
The reason I ask is I have two kids. Mm-hmm. Both of them are older, 10, older than 10 years old. Mm-hmm. I was, of course, when they were 2-3 years old, I was reading the books for them. And suddenly I realized when they were 4 or 5 years old already, they get so grown up Because kids today, they use so much multimedia and so on, and then they will, either they will stick on the mobile, right. watch all the time without really knowing what they're watching, mm-hmm. or they drop the interest very quickly. So I think for different countries, there might be the age difference. Mm-hmm. Maybe for some countries, this will target for children are the same book will target a children for 7 years old. For others, it's only for 4 years old.
Yeah, right. That's yeah. right.
And yeah, if we look at the, there was another one with the giraffe. Only.
Giraffe?
Yeah, oh. I love the giraffe. It's good drawing.
Oh.
Oh, this
I know
one is
what
okay.
it is.
Yeah, you know what is it?
Oh, okay.
It's very good drawing.
This one.
Yes, that one above.
Do you like it?
I really awesome. Like the drawing, okay. but I have a question. It's like, how exciting if you're a kid when you see a giraffe with 2D, a picture, and then you saw a 3D. Mm-hmm. And then you can twist it, but then later you are thinking about, oh, maybe we should go to the zoo to see a real one.
Exactly, yes.
Yeah. The reason I'm talking is I think this is a great technology. And if you could just improve a little bit, I think this can be a whole new thing. Mm-hmm. Because I think the book is too well printed. Which I mean that I didn't want to see the giraffe on the book. But, you know, I think if you could show something different from the book, and when they scan it, they got a giraffe. For example, on the book, if it's only written, which animal has the longest neck in the world? And the children have to think.
Okay.
And when they scan it, they got the answer, which is a giraffe in 3D. So the thing is, I think the right now, the function of the book and the function of the app mm-hmm. is kind of similar. It's a little bit better. But if you let the book to raise up a question, and through the app, you give the answer of the question, suddenly there is a huge meaning of the book. Otherwise, maybe the children will only play with the app.
Okay, that's good advice, yes.
Yeah. So that's why I think you should, you can think more about the relationship between the book and the app. The app shouldn't be only a copy of the book, a little bit alive. The app can do even more things from the book.
Exactly.
Yeah. And it's, I also wonder like where you get the book. Do you have to use the traditional distribution channels? Then maybe the book will limit the customer. For example, I can mm-hmm. pay a monthly fee. I will use the app, but I didn't have time to go to the bookstore to get the physical book. Mm-hmm. And finally, the children will not use it. So this is also...
So that's why we built a web platform. Mm. So you can go to the website, regardless of where you are, mm. and then you can just put up the contents. Mm. For example, you just open the TagMe 3D, which is Word Phonics Book Series. Then you download the applications. Mm. Then you scan the browser screen, or you can also print them out, and then you can make your own books as well.
Yeah. Yeah. I think from the very beginning, I mean, it's not no point to avoid the books. Mm-hmm. But if you can find, for example, you can work with the school and the school will get different questions for children to answer. Mm-hmm. And if they can scan or take a photo of that question and they will get the answer to check if they're right or not, you get the point.
Yeah,
that makes the normal school work more interesting.
Okay.
So I think it's worth to spend more time to think what you really have, mm-hmm. what the function of the book. And later, if you can take photos in a park, for example, suddenly you can add, for example, the Swedish orientation activity. You go to a place, you take a photo of the tree, and then you raise up a question, you have to choose which of the animal live there, and then you arrive, and you go to the next spot, you go the physical training. This is a Swedish orientation activity.
Okay.
And I think this technology is really, really interesting. Mm-hmm. And you have went so far with the technology itself. Now it's time to keep the technology and go back to the market and think what kind of product you have really developed.
Yeah.
And I think it's really interesting. And I think we have more time to talk about it tomorrow.
Sure. And also, that's what makes our products the best. Because just the idea you gave me is actually a number of ideas that people give us. But our products, our contents always can be transformed to different types, different package. just like I said before, it can be also in the theme park, AFR center. So many different ways. We have so many possibilities with using existing content.
Exactly. So. And how about, for example, I want to thank the appreciation. My appreciation for this book is very well prepared. And we have the slides and we have different company presentation. Mm-hmm. Imagine if I'm using your app and taking a picture of the first company, mm-hmm. and then what I get is not the presentation about this company, but is there a matchmaking company in Finland?
Exactly.
Then
that's
it's
awesome.
Getting
yes.
very interesting.
That's
Imagine
interesting.
If I have a book of about 20 single girls in each page. And then when I take a photo of them, I will get their dreaming guys. Mm-hmm. Then definitely, I don't think the 3D picture has to be exactly the same as the 2D one. If you think more, I think you will have a huge market with that.
Yes, that's what we do, actually. The second one, Victoria AI, is just for that, just to make new visualizations of the any kinds of sort of it's a book, or if it's name card, brochures, anything can be work in AR technology. So thank you for the advice.
Yeah, and also it's worth to see that if this technology can be used in other things, maybe a new kind of glasses, mm-hmm. maybe you have exclusive rights to deal with Samsung. So next time, only when you use the Samsung phone, you will get this function, but not with Apple. For example.
Wow. Yeah, you know exactly what we do, actually. We also can add the contents to AR glasses as well. This is why it's so powerful, because it's so expendable. It doesn't matter what hardware you're using. Yeah.
So. Exactly. Good. I'm very happy that you will include us mm-hmm. as your customer, not only under 7 years, 10
right.
years old, but
right.
we are looking forward for this app.
Yes.
Thank you
so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Next up is Blueprint Lab. Blueprint Lab transforms products from a digital input into a configurable format for visual customization. Please invite Shin Seung Sik, the CEO of Blueprint Lab, to the stage. Please give him a big hand. I want something just like
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Charlie Shin, CEO of Blueprint Lab. Blueprint Lab is providing custom product recommendation and manufacturing solutions for enterprise companies with facial recognition and AI technology. Let's think about mass production product. Most of mass production products are single size, even though every person has different face. And most of 2D-based solutions need high computing power, like a server, which is big and expensive. That's why we are developing 3D-based facial recognition solution with AI technology. Now we are working with two different kind of projects. The first one is we are working with DaVinci Eyewear Company, which is the biggest eyewear franchise company in Korea, to make customized glasses. And also, we are collaborating with Amore Pacific, which is the largest cosmetic company in Korea, to make a customized facial mask pack. Let me play a short video clip that tells you how the product works. So users are able to use their smartphone to scan their face. So our AI algorithm analyzes the user's face based on the scan. So users also can do virtual try-on for glasses product like this. And also, our solution allows that measuring each part of face without any other extra devices, such as, for example, distance between eyes or width of face. For the IR market size, it was $9.3 billion in 2014 already for the only East Asia. And it is going to be $16.4 billion in 2019. So it's very promising market. And also for the mask pack market, It was already $6 billion in 2016 only for Chinese market. And it is going to be growing up to $12 billion in 2020. It's almost double. So let's talk about competition. We are using 3D image processing, unlike the, any other 2D-based competitors are using 2D-based 2D image data. So our solution is much more faster and lighter than our competitors. And also, we are operating our solution on mobile devices like iPhone, new iPad. And also, our virtual try-on, we are providing our virtual try-on. It's a real-time virtual try-on based on the one-on-one size matching. So the face and the, we are matching face, user face and the custom product. So it's more, you can feel the more realistic. So we are thinking of two different kind of business model. So we are going to charge a one-time payment when we are providing our solution to companies. And also we are thinking of 10% of royalty when custom products are sold through our solution. The custom glasses and mask pack is just the start. We are expanding our the business to any other various custom product manufacturing industry, such as dental devices, cosmetic devices. Except one designer and one 3D modeler, rest of our teammates are all the developers. So I'm saying that we are definitely a tech startup, and David Lee, CEO of NVIDIA Korea, he's helping us in business and technical side. So recently, we are accepted by the NVIDIA Inception program, which is providing hardware and software, and even the training program for deep learning development. So we built a wide global network in the US and East Asia, even in Europe, to expand our business to global market. So we are Blueprint Lab. Blueprint Lab is providing the custom product recommendation and manufacturing solution for enterprise. Thank you.
Thank you so much for the
Thank
presentation.
You.
What's really interesting, I think, about what you're doing is the technology. Mm-hmm. I think that right now you're looking at the eyewear market and the facial mask, and
yes.
I think it's quite a narrow space to
yes.
think about just that. I mean, I don't wear glasses myself, but I could imagine that, yeah, maybe some people have a problem when they have to go to the optic and fit the glasses, but I don't know if it's a huge problem globally, or like when I do my facial masks, mm-hmm. I probably wouldn't want to spend tons of time trying to customize, because it's going to be on my face for 10 minutes, literally, and then I get it off.
Yeah.
So I think that thinking about just those two, although I saw you put how much there's like the market opportunity and so on, but I think you guys should think wider, because what's interesting is the technology. What else can you do with that? And you mentioned a couple of things, but I wanted to ask you whether that same technology can be used for not just customizing something that you're wearing or dental, but actually for digital use, for example, facial recognition out of, say you want to do like media monitoring, right? Mm. So a lot of the companies do that, right? You put in keywords and everywhere, you know, George Clooney is mentioned, uh-huh. then, you know, you'll get a, you'll get a notification. Hmm. What if you could take his face and see, even if nobody says, this is George Clooney, it actually recognizes that he's been in this particular photo, mm-hmm. right? And I know I worked previously at a SaaS company that was doing online media tracking and monitoring. And one of the things that a lot of the customers ask were, do you do like picture monitoring? Are you able to recognize, you know, pictures? And one thing is, of course, facial recognition. The other one then is, would you be able to use that same technology to recognize brands? If I have a, you know, like a bottle of Perrier water and it's somewhere in social media, would mm-hmm. Perrier be able to track this based on certain, you know, branding or whatnot? I don't know if the technology is the same, but just kind of like to think a little bit wider of what is it that you can do. Mm-hmm. And obviously, I think that the brand recognition is one thing, and the facial recognition, which is much more, I think, complex to do, could be very interesting. And then you can expand it beyond just somebody wanting to monitor George Clooney, but actually trying to see if you can monitor, I don't know, if Interpol can monitor where some of the suspects are, for example, or things like that. So really kind of thinking bigger than just customizing the eyewear. Okay, I really like the opportunities that the technology provides.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, because I was wondering too, even you yourself don't wear glasses.
Sometimes I wear glasses, not this time. Yeah.
But you know how many Chinese women came to South Korea and to do this face surgery?
True.
Yes, and I think if you could use this technology on them, mm-hmm. give them suggestions, there will be less failure. Because the doctor could basically change their face however he wants, mm-hmm. but they will have a better communication before. Yeah. And I think for the same technology, you get much more paid.
Yeah,
if you end it with a good, business area.
So yeah, we are thinking of our, we are working with Amore Perspic, the cosmetic company. So we are targeting their premium customers at the first time.
Yeah.
So from the premium market, we want to penetrate the general market, common market.
So if that is a business secret that you don't want to talk here, I think you should talk loudly when you come to Finland.
Okay.
Because that one is really impressive, and they will understand the market, the potential, uh-huh. and you will have a much more chance to get investment.
Okay.
And also, I wonder that is your technology only usable on face, or you can scan the whole body?
If you want to scan any other object, like a bottle, it's possible.
Okay, because when you're able to scan a body, then you can come to the tailor-made suits and clothes, the other business.
That's true, yeah.
Anyhow, I think we think the glasses is a good try, but it's too limited for your technology.
Thank you for your feedback.
Thank you.
Thank you. Gives some superhero,
some fairy tale bliss. Thank you. Next, we have Tone 28. Tone 28 offers subscription services of customized cosmetic based on skin data and climate change. I'd like to invite Park Jun-soo, the CEO of Tone 28, to the stage. Please welcome him with a warm round of applause. You probably think that you are better now, you only say that because I'm not around,
not around. You know I never meant to let you down. Hi, I'm Jun-soo Park. And CEO of Tone 28. Can you see these pictures? Does this person look same? Yeah, right, the same person. What makes the differentiation? His right side and left side. I think you already know. He's a truck driver for 30 years. His right side is exposed by weather factor, like dust and high and low temperatures and the sunshine. Yes. But some people say genetic factor already determine the skin conditions. But skin conditions is more affected by environmental factor. So we decided to put the flag on 70% spot on there. I think it's something wrong, okay. The white line is the real data. Our skin is alive and changed like that. If you wanna get the personalized beauty on August, you can get the right personalized beauty, but time goes on, it could be not right. So customized beauty should be aligned with their skin change based on the weather factor. Like fresh milk, you subscribe, we deliver a fresh skincare right in your home. Absolutely. You can get the changeable skincare by our weather big data algorithm. And we solved two more problems that the cosmetic industry face. The first is we reverse the price structures that the most companies follow. You can see that. And the second is we reduce the plastic usage by 92%. How we can do this? Yes, we can do this by using the real paper package. This is our cosmetic package. Some people say it's cute. Some people say it's ugly. But most people say it's good for nature. Our customer is who have economic power and worth more to pay for social value than luxury goods. And we made 6,000 members at the first year, and we are making 20,000 members at this year. And we focus on now get the brand loyalty and data gathering with the real measurement. The next step, we are gonna aim at the scalability with the semi-custom without the real measurement. This is our semi-custom images. I can scale up, maintaining the operating profit by 30%. Like make it more colorful and make it lower price than our first step service. We are, our team is composed with experts from the various fields, like data and cosmetics and sales. From now on, so far, convenience changed the world. But from now on, inconvenience changed the world. How about to move with the tone to A for the nature and for your skin? Thank you.
Thank you so much for the interesting presentation. You concentrated a lot on the packaging in your presentation, but what I'm really curious to hear is more about the actual product, because that's the actual product, right?
That's right.
What's inside of the container. Because I love the environmental factor, but really it's the content, right, of what you're selling. So is that something you guys develop in-house? Is that cosmetic? Is it like a lotion, or is it something you drink, or what's the actual product in a sense?
It's a good question. Thank you. You guys just one solution. We don't call that a cream, don't call the lotion, don't call the skin. Because the expert who make the cosmetic already know that. That's the unwritten law. That's the same ingredient. Mm-hmm. Same ingredient. Just put some sticky stuff, it can be, it changed to the lotion, it changed to cream. Mm-hmm. So we say it doesn't need that. So we just make one.
So what do you call cream. It? Like
we called butter gari.
Wow. Okay.
It's too hard to the foreigner.
What does it mean? Is it just? Do you literally say this is a product for your skin?
Yes. Butter gari means like a It's too tough to explain.
Okay, like no worries. But basically, it's not a cream. It's okay. But I got the idea. You want to call it something different. You mentioned in 2018 you had like 20,000 subscribers, right?
Yes.
From 6,000 to 20,000, like members. You call them members, right?
Right.
So they basically subscribe to the monthly. Is that correct?
Right, right.
Was that the data, right? So right. That you have 20,000 like customers, essentially, right? Did I understand correctly?
Sorry. Our active customer is the 5,000 members now. Okay. That's the accumulative numbers.
Okay, got it. Okay. And are they all from Korea?
Yeah, only Korea.
Only Korea.
Yes.
Got it. I mean, my biggest question, I suppose, here is really what is that thing that's not a cream or a lotion or whatnot? Because I'm thinking if I put something on my face, I want to make sure that that's something, you know, really useful. I don't want to just put stuff that I don't know of. So that would be my kind of question number one. What's exactly, how do you develop it? Do you have like dermatologists there involved and scientists and how have you come up with that? And then maybe the second, because you mentioned about the environmental bit and that monthly you get something to your home, that packet, and it includes something, but is that based on data on your skin or just the weather?
Ah, yes. First question, we put very authorized the ingredients like 10 times or 20 times more than the other products. Mm-hmm. So after 3 months, the people knows the skin has been better than before.
But does that have to do with people, because people have individual skins, right? Like some people,
right.
You know, need more of this and more of that and so on. So do you do that analysis as well? Or you just send everything to everybody based on some environmental?
We measure the person's skin, every person's. We visit and we measure just first time. And then they got the subscription of the cosmetic. The fit to their skin. Mm. And we check when they want to check their skin one more time, we go there, mm-hmm. the last time there. So we check and we show the data to him and they and repay about that, so.
Okay. Well, I mean, yeah, from maybe a little tip in terms of the actual presentation is I would really encourage you to concentrate more on that rather than the packaging, because I think the packaging is like a great addition. Oh, we also are environmental friendly, which is important. But I think that what people really are looking to hear is what is it? What's the secret sauce? How do you measure it? How do you develop it? How is it customized? So I'd really encourage you just to talk more about the product, what's inside.
First of all, I really like the packaging. It's very
Thank
Scandinavian
you.
Somehow. It's simple, basic, environmental friendly. I think the package will have a good response from Helsinki. But I have the same question with Anna. Like, I didn't get what the product is really about. I think probably half of the people here in this hall know exactly what it's about. And even will be less of the people will think, hey, this is something for me. So I think in the presentation, it will be really smart if you could have one or two sentences after showing this old man's face, okay. saying that we have a product, no matter if it's cream or what, but mm-hmm. you tell what you use it for. Do I need to use it daily or when, in the evening, in the morning? Mm-hmm. That status has to be very clear. People will think, oh, this is for me, this is for my friend, this is nothing for me, I will move away. Because right now, we're all sitting, and this is a very calm location. But Slash in Finland is very crowded, full of companies, a lot of things going on.
Yeah.
If they don't get the point, after five sentences, they will move to the next venue, next section.
Okay.
Then you will have a very hard time to get the attention and keep them, and it's very important to be short, concrete, clear, and later on the website they can hear all this add value, vision, environmental protection, sustainability. But for your presentation, you have to get the key point.
Okay, I fully understand that.
And maybe one quick other tip is that while I understand that this older man's face is very impactful, your audience is probably not going to be truck drivers of 30 years, right? Like you said, your main customer is the woman who wants to spend money. So can you somehow tailor that? Like, can you show, is there a difference in that woman's face after whatever using your product? Like, customize a little bit more to the audience. Because otherwise, I'm looking at this man and I'm like, I'm not him and I'll never be. Okay. So, you know, so it doesn't resonate as much as something that I could relate to. So
okay,
maybe consider that. Although it's powerful, but maybe at least the next picture to show, okay, this is also how your face can look like.
I fully understand that. Okay, yeah. Thank you.
A great job.
Thank you. You probably think that you are better now.